Hello, I'm Craig Foster, and one of the things that's connecting me to God right now is the weekly preparation of the AV for our worship services. Now, this may sound a little bit strange, but everything that you see on your screen at home has to be put into a computer so it will show up in the right order. And so every scripture text I read through and figure out where the breaks are and where the breaths are going to be and where the pauses need to be. Every hymn and every song that we sing, I go through the words and make sure that the breaks are at the right place so you can breathe in the right place. And as I'm doing that, I have to sing the songs. And I often sing them over and over and over again in that process. For morning song, Lisa sometimes puts in a video of it, so I'll play those videos over and over again as I'm going through the song, getting it ready. And then there are those wonderful garage concerts or garage songs that we've been getting from the choir, and those I'll watch and listen to over and over again to make sure that the sound is right and the video is right, but also just to let it sink in. Sometimes I just put those on a loop and let them go over and over again while I'm working on the rest of the service. During the service, I'm often unfortunately distracted by lots of things, making sure the technology is working right, making sure that I know what I'm doing next in the service. But that time getting ready for the service is holy time for me, a prayerful time for me when I feel very connected to God. So now let's turn to the Bible and continue our journey through the Gospel of Mark. Today with Mark chapter 3, starting at verse 20. Listen for God's word to you. Jesus entered a house. A crowd gathered again so that it was impossible for him and his followers to eat. When his family heard what was happening, they came to take control of him. They were saying, "He's out of his mind." The legal experts came down from Jerusalem. Over and over they charged, "He's possessed by Beelzebul. He throws out demons with the authority of the ruler of demons." When Jesus called them together, he spoke to them in a parable. "How can Satan throw Satan out? A kingdom involved in civil war will collapse. A house torn apart by divisions will collapse. If Satan rebels against himself and is divided, then he can't endure. He's done for. No one gets into the house of a strong person and steals anything without first tying up the strong person. Only then can the house be burglarized. I assure you that human beings will be forgiven for everything, for all sins and insults of every kind, but whoever insults the Holy Spirit will never be forgiven. That person is guilty of a sin with consequences that last forever." He said this because the legal experts were saying he's possessed by a holy spirit. His mother and brothers arrived. They stood outside and sent word to him, calling for him. A crowd was seated around him, and those sent to him said, "Look, your mother, brothers, and sisters are outside looking for you." He replied, "Who is my mother? Who are my brothers?" Looking around at those seated around him in a circle, he said, "Look, my mother and my brothers. Whoever does God's will is my brother, sister, and mother." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.